In the 2020 presidential election, 72% of Pennsylvanians turned out to vote. Now, you know, another 6-7 months later, we're going to make the attempt to diminish that majority. We're going to make the attempt to avoid democracy, to sort of sidestep that outpouring of voters themselves with a voting reform bill that is anything but reform. We should be talking about those education challenges, those kids. We should be talking about jobs, healthcare, equity, quality of life. Instead, we're trying to undermine our election services capabilities, our ability to conduct broad and sweeping elections with great turnout that would enable us to take on the really big challenges we face. Instead, we're rehashing the last presidential election. Still, we've done the statistical audit. We also did a larger audit to include 63 of 67 counties in Pennsylvania. We spent over 30 hours in state government committee hearings listening to expert testimony. And what we learned is that Pennsylvania can do some things a little better, but we learned those experts, over 50 experts testifying from across Pennsylvania and from other states, what we learned is that our 2020 election was solid, fair, secure. And we learned that we also owe a great debt of gratitude to the county election services people who made that happen. We could thank them with some real support for those really big issues, better schools for their children, jobs in their communities, healthcare, equity. Instead, we got a Voter Restriction Act. The proponents of this bill are going to use words like reform and improved access. Here's what they will be saying. If we limit voter registration, we create more access. If we limit mail-in ballots, we create more access. If we limit drop boxes, we create more access. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Chair, thanks, gentlemen.
Right time for Pennsylvania to think big and better. Thank you.